So the third property that I want to look at with you is the graph. And so it turns out that the graph of f inverse of x is just the graph of y equals f of x reflected over the line y equals x. You just quite literally take the graph of f, you flip it over the line y equals x, and you get the graph of f inverse of x. So that's a really key fact to know. We'll do examples of that in a little bit. Right now I want to just get these properties down. So I want you to realize, though, that once you know property 3, property 4 follows immediately. Okay? So, not quite. Once you know property 3, you should believe property 4. Property 4 is going to be a little bit more, but here we go. If f of x, if our function is continuous on some interval I, then it turns out, here's the new part, it turns out that f of I is also an interval. It's an interval of the y-axis, can't have holes or breaks in it. And here's the cool part, it shouldn't surprise you, and f inverse is continuous on the interval f of I. And at this point you may be having a hard time keeping straight in your mind what does all of this mean. So the key takeaway here is really number 3. It tells you that what does the graph of f inverse look like? It looks like the graph of f reflected over this line. That's the key takeaway. And from that we sort of expect that, hey, if f is continuous, I somehow expect the inverse function to be continuous. And that's really what 4 is giving you a little more precise detail about that. We'll see this played out. All right, so those are the basic properties. We're going to use these again and again and again. The first two especially are just absolutely fundamental. You've seen these before. Hopefully you've seen 3 as well. So 1, 2, and 3 are really critical that we know these. And 4 I wanted to write down as well for completeness sake. All right, so there's a natural question that pops up here. We've talked about domain, range. We've talked about how you can compose a function with its inverse. You always get out x. We've talked about the graph of these things. And we've even talked about continuity. But what about the derivative? Hopefully you were thinking that. What about the derivative of the inverse function? And so let's go ahead and hopefully I've not been zoomed out this whole time. That would be very sad if I was. Let's talk about this. So, question. So what about differentiability of f of x? Sorry, f inverse of x. So given a function, I want to know, can you take the derivative of the inverse function? And if so, how does it work? And so to answer this question, let's actually slide this down. We'll make a new page here. To answer this question, and for whatever reason, I'm having a hard time with the mouse today. There we go. That didn't look very readable. There we go. Differentiability. Okay. So let's start with the fact that f of f inverse of x is just x. And I want you to realize that on this side, I can actually take derivatives using the chain rule. And on this side, I can take the derivative and I just get 1. So think with me. Let's think carefully through the chain rule. The chain rule says if you want to take a derivative of a composition, it's the derivative of the outside, plug in the inside, times the derivative of the inside. Got it? Derivative of the outside, plug in the inside, times the derivative of the inside. And so I'm going to do that. So I'm going to get f prime of f inverse of x times, now this is the part that gets a little weird, f inverse prime of x. I have to be careful how I write all of this, right? So this is f inverse of x times f inverse prime of x. And by the way, that's just one because we know this identity. And so you think about it, I want to actually solve for the inverse prime. And so when I do that, I get f inverse prime of x is 1 over f prime of f inverse of x. Now there is a caveat here, right? So long as f prime of f inverse of x is not 0. That would be a problem if it was. All right, so we just discovered this nice little relationship. So I'm going to break this video here, and in the next video we'll write that down formally. And then I want to work out some examples with you.